Okay. Any ideas of how we can take this equation and find some points or graph that?
We can put 0 in for x and 3 in for y.
0 in for x. So we put 0 in for x, then we'll get, well, nothing there, right? 4y equals 12 divided by 4, and y is 3. Pretty easy, plugging 0 in for x, something we've done before.
Plug in 1 for x and 1.5 for 4.
For y?
For, yeah, y.
Okay, so we plug in 1 for x. 5 for y and see if it works out. 6 plus, this is 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. Okay? So 1 and 1.5. Is there anything easier than that?
Yes.
Kyler?
2 for x and 0 for y.
So here's how I'm going to look at that. 6x plus 4 times. 0, right, according to what Kyler just said?
Yeah.
Right. So the same way that we plug in 0 for x, you can plug in 0 for y. There's no reason we can't plug something in for y. It's just that we haven't before because it wasn't very convenient. But when it's written in this way, standard form, then all of a sudden it is convenient because it eliminates the y term. We just get 6x equals 12 divided by 6. X is 2. So when y is 0, and x is 2. So we got 3 points here. I would submit these two are the easiest ones that we could find. We can find any points we want. We can plug anything we want in for x, 1, right? 6 times 1 plus 4 times y. Okay, so we have 6. We'll subtract 6 from both sides. So 4y equals, equals 6. We subtract 6 from both sides. Divide by 4, and y equals 1.5. So fine. But it's a little harder to solve that equation. It's even harder to guess that 1 and 1.5 are the correct numbers. So I would say 0 for x, 0 for y, pretty simple.
To make it easier, could you find what y equals? Where you were like, what? Well, I just did it. Y equals 12 minus 6x divided by 4.
So you solve for y, which is another strategy, which is going to be part of the homework, writing it the way it used to look, right, in the slope-intercept. So Molly's saying, how about if we subtract 6x from both sides, get 4y equal, that's not 4y, that's yy. 4y equals negative 6x plus 12, I'm just going to write it that way, in that order, it's the same thing. And then divide by 4 on both sides. Y equals negative 6 fourths x plus 12 over 4. Right, dividing everything by 4 here. Negative 3 halves x plus 3. Certainly we could write it that way. Now it's like it used to be. We would plug in a 0 for x, and then we plug in a 2 for x, or negative 2, or anything that's divisible by 2.
But we don't have to do that.
No, we don't. Well, there will be at least one homework, maybe two homework questions where that is what it's going to ask you to do. Okay. This would be what you would call rewrite in slope-intercept form. So it says rewrite in slope-intercept form. That's exactly what it's talking about. Try that again.
So you can just pretty much you can pretty much put 4 over anything.
You can pretty much put 4 over anything.
No, like you could put 4 over x.
And 12 over 4.
Gotcha.
Right.
4
over x and
12
over 4.
Yeah. Like, I mean, yeah.
Negative 6x over 4 and 12 over 4, yeah? So, there's a couple of strategies. We're going to cover this one more than this one, but this is just, it's solving what we call a literal equation. You're solving for y, getting y by itself. Once you have y by itself, you have it back in slope and intercept form. Of course, these two, whether you do it this way or you do it this way and use the y-intercept and the slope, as we have been doing, they'll make the same graph, of course. Okay? Okay. let's do try this, okay? By this I mean 0 for x, 0 for y. Give this a try on this equation, negative 3x plus 4y plus 4y equals 12.
Like finding the minor again?
So, the thing that I had to practice was plugging a 0 in for x, finding the y, plugging a 0 in for y, and finding the x. So it's written like this. It's a convenient thing to do. So what happens when you plug in a 0 for x?
I think it's rid of the x.
It's rid of the x. So we set 4y equals 12, right?
Mm-hmm.
It goes away. Divide by 4 on both sides, y is 3. Okay, now we do the opposite. We just plug in 0 for y now, and we get negative 3x equals 12, and x equals
negative 4.
There's our point at 0, 3. X is 0, y is 3. There's a point at negative 4, 0. And there we go, 2 points. Tell us which way the line is going. Our line. Our better line.
Wait, why do you have to
map it? What's that?
Oh, wait, never mind.
So, if we have an equation in standard form, we can always 0 for x, 0 for y. Okay? If we have a point that looks like 0, y value, since this will just be 0 means it's on the y-axis, means this guy is the y-intercept. If y is 0, that means we're on, where is this point? If y is 0, on the x-axis, so this guy is what we call the x-intercept. This is where the line crosses the, or intercepts the y-axis. This is where it intercepts the x-axis. So, if you have an equation in standard form, ax plus by equals c, we can quickly find the graph of the line by doing what?
Graphing
of it. What's that?
0 for x,
0 for y. 0 for x, find y. 0 for y, find x. One last word about standard form. Here's a real world example where it makes sense to write your equation in standard form. Before we were writing equations in what we call slope intercept form, and it made sense because it was like a rate, 5 miles per hour. And then some initial value, okay? So like we had an equation like this before, y equals 5x plus 2, right? And that could be like I make $5 an hour and an extra $2. Just get an extra $2, okay, so whoever I'm working for just thinks I'm swell and just gives me $2. And we get $5 an hour, here's x dollars. That made sense for that kind of a story. This kind of a story, it makes more sense to write it in standard form. You probably can't read this because it's kind of dark. It says 60 cents per pound. Apples say 150 per pound. And you have $6 to spend. You kind of started to write this equation, something plus something needs to equal something else. Okay, so you've caught on already. Something plus something should equal the $6 that I have to spend.
Right here.
Yes?
60 goes right there.
60 cents. Goes right there? 60 cents. Just 60 cents?
X.
0.6 times x. Now what does x
represent? The number. Banana.
Number of pounds.
Number of pounds of?
Banana.
Banana.
And then
banana.
One,
yes.
150. Y, apple.
Good. Why? Not X. Why don't I put an X there?
Because it's different.
Well, probably different. Not guaranteed to be different, but probably different. Okay? So, number of pounds of apples. So 0.6 times X, that's Yeah, 0.6 times the number of pounds of bananas is going to be the money I spend on bananas, right? This is going to be the money that I spend on apples. And when I add them both together, I get money. Total.
$6.
$6 total. So that's an equation that I could use. I could plug an X in there, then solve for Y, and I'll know that that's how many pounds of bananas I should get, and this is how many pounds of apples that I should get to add up to exactly $6. If we use the strategy that we just learned for this standard form equation, how would we find a couple of points?
Right here. Put 0 in for X.
0 in for X, and that'll give us 1.5y equals 6.
Which would equal 4.
And then you
4,
would
so we'll get a 4 for Y. Wait. What does this point represent? What have you done when you're at the store? Did you have this point 0, 4? What does that represent that you've done when you went to the store?
Easter.
Aiden?
Yeah. You spent money?
Yes. How much money did you spend?
40 cents.
You spent 40 cents?
$4.
No. We spent $6. No matter what here, we're supposed to spend $6. So what's the 4 mean?
What's the what?
What does 4 represent?
$4, four pounds of apples.
Pounds of what? Using.
Apples,
right? Y is pounds of apples. 4 is what Y is. It's 0, 4. We can plug in 0 for Y.
And get 10.
And get 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What does that represent?
Number of pounds of bananas.
Number of pounds of bananas?
Which equals 6. Like, in all, that equals 6.
$6?
Yeah.
If you buy 10 pounds of bananas, it'll cost you, this should all cost you $6. It should always cost you $6. Exactly. Right? So this represents, I bought 4 pounds of apples and how many pounds of bananas?
10.
4.
This point, right here.
10.
Zero. 0 pounds of bananas, 4 pounds of apples. I spent all $6 on only apples. Over here, what does this represent?
Just bananas.
No bananas.
Only bananas. No apples, 10 pounds of bananas, and no apples. Okay. And this line in between, with all of these infinite numbers of points, what are all those points represent?
The
fractions.
Yeah, like fractions of pounds of bananas and apples. I could buy 5 pounds of bananas and looks like 2 pounds of apples. 5 pounds of bananas, 2 pounds of apples.
Mm-hmm.
Here, there. If I buy 2 pounds of bananas,
okay.
1.25 kind of get, or 3.25 pounds of apples or whatever, right? It's just different combinations of apples and bananas, not just all bananas or all apples. This is all apples. This is all bananas.
Or
it's a combination of apples. Yes. All right. So, just to recap, 0 for X, 0 for Y.
Mm-hmm.
It's written in standard form. That's a really easy thing to do to find 2 points.
Mm-hmm.
There's an example of a real life situation where it makes sense for your equation to be in standard form. Any questions? Richard?
Could there be a different problem that has nothing to do with this, but it's on the test? Not like the actual test problem, but one that is similar to it.
Started. You're already going to finish it all this time in between. But as always, if you do finish and you decide you don't like that score, then you can go over any questions you want with you one-on-one, and then you can retake it.
That's what I need to do after this test, because I don't know how to